Lewis Hamilton has finally signed on the dotted line and extended his contract with Mercedes to the end of the 2021 season. The contract saga had stretched for so long and there were multiple speculations around what the delay could have been. But when all is said and done, we have Mercedes and Lewis Hamilton extending their association for one more year. Talking about the contract extension, let's bifurcate the good, the bad and the ugly from this latest development. First of all, let's talk about the good that came out of this announcement. I guess the biggest positive that comes out from this latest development, at least from my point of view, is how Lewis has backed up his words with actions. Lewis spent the bulk of the 2020 season talking about global events, Black Lives Matter and social inclusion. He would bend the knee before the start of the race. He would make it a point to talk about what was going on in the world. If there was something wrong and needed attention, then he made it a point to bring it to everyone's notice. But usually behind all this, the world would call you a hypocrite if all you do is just talk about things and not take any action. Lewis, however, has bucked the trend as he made it a point to talk about how a foundation was being launched to support diversity and inclusion in the sport. It seems that Lewis has finally realized the kind of weight his voice carries across the globe, and he's making it a point to utilize it for the betterment of the world. Another positive, arguably for the Lewis Hamilton fans, is that Lewis, by extending his contract to the end of 2021, gives himself the opportunity to take a shot at the record-breaking 8th world title. Hamilton currently stands at 7 world titles, tied with Michael Schumacher, and by winning the 8th one, he would break the record for the most world titles in Formula 1. By driving a Mercedes, a car that hasn't lost since 2014, Lewis Hamilton, who himself hasn't lost since 2016, is certainly the favorite to break the record. Now, let's switch the tempo and move to what is the bad part of the announcement. I guess it would be evident that the bad would mostly revolve around Lewis Hamilton signing an extension for just 1 year. One clear indication from the contract duration that we can decipher is that the extension was nothing more than a stopgap arrangement by both the parties, either because of a paucity of time to discuss or to end the standoff between the two parties. As a result, it seems that either Lewis Hamilton does not have complete faith in how the German team is going to fare when the new regulations apply from the 2022 season, or on the other hand, Mercedes have started to look beyond Lewis Hamilton and want to keep their options open for the next season. For Lewis, he knows that the regulations are changing from the 2022 season, and one of the primary aspects would be a huge reduction in budgets for the top teams that would eventually lead to a closer field. The emphasis would be on efficiency more than anything. Now, Mercedes has always had one of the bigger budgets on the grid. They would surely need to cut down on their expenses and still try to produce the fastest car on the grid with a limited budget. Will they be able to bring in a level of efficiency to their operations that still keeps them at the front of the grid? The answer to that is unknown and could put the Mercedes dominance under threat under the new regulations. For Mercedes, on their part, questions have already been asked around the salary and the benefits provided to Hamilton, especially when Mercedes is actually firing people from various departments all across the globe. To add to this, Hamilton at 37 might not be as good a prospect as a hungry Max Verstappen waiting for his first title at Red Bull. A one-year deal primarily shows that the marriage between the driver and the team is not at its strongest right now, and we could be looking at the end of the iconic Lewis Hamilton-Mercedes partnership. Now, let's switch focus to the ugly part of the announcement. Well, most strong and successful partnerships in Formula 1 end when the team or the driver starts looking for ways to move on. Such a thing happened when Ayrton Senna wanted to move from McLaren to Williams. And the perfect case in point was what happened between Ferrari and Michael Schumacher in 2006. Michael Schumacher was 37 at that time. He was already a 7-time world champion, but his contract was coming to an end. At the same time, young blood in the form of Kimi Raikkonen and Fernando Alonso had emerged, and the Italian team, keeping their eyes on the future, decided to sign Kimi Raikkonen for the 2007 season. What this did was it led to Michael Schumacher, the driver that had brought glory to the team, announce his retirement in 2006. Lewis Hamilton is on the same boat at this point in time. At 36, he's not the youngest driver on the grid, and with Max Verstappen and Charles Leclerc and George Russell starting to come into their own, it's already tough to pick who is the best driver on the grid. I always believe there's no smoke without fire, and it is plausible that Mercedes might have declined Lewis Hamilton's demands of a bigger wage and a veto clause for his teammate, and instead offered Lewis a 1-year extension. If Hamilton was 30 years old and he had demanded a veto clause in his contract, it's hard to argue Mercedes would have said no. But at 36, Hamilton doesn't have that many years left in the game. And Mercedes might just have decided to give Lewis his one final shot at glory and the record in 2021, and then move on to either a Max Verstappen or a George Russell in 2022. 2021 could just be the final year of Lewis Hamilton's Formula One career. And it starts with Lewis losing out in a power struggle against Mercedes. Now, these are my views regarding the good, the bad, and the ugly around the Lewis Hamilton contract extension. What do you guys think? Do share in the comment section, and please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.